Hi, everyone. My name is Angelos, and I'm a program manager for .NET. When our code is source controlled under GitHub.com, we have the opportunity of using GitHub Actions to set up CICD, continuous integration, continuous deployment. Let's take a look at how Visual Studio can help us configure CICD via GitHub Actions for deployments to Azure with just a few clicks. So here I am in Visual Studio. I'm going to right-click on my project and select Publish. I'm going to pick Azure and Azure App Service Linux as my final publish destination. And here, Visual Studio is helping me manage all of my Azure resources without leaving the IDE. On the top right corner, I have my account picker. So even if I'm logged in with multiple accounts, I can switch between them. And by the way, if you guys have a Visual Studio subscription, that comes with free Azure credits. So make sure those are activated and you're logged in with it. If you have multiple Azure subscriptions, Visual Studio helps you pick the right one to filter the list by with this dropdown. You can look at the existing resources, either grouped by resource group, because some people like to keep application dependencies together all in one place. So that's helpful. That's the default view. But you can also flip it over to a flat view if you're trying to find something alphabetically. You can search for things if you're almost sure what the name is. And of course, you can always create new instances without leaving the IDE. But in this case, I'm just going to pick an existing instance because it's just easy. Now I'm going to click Next and check this out. So at this point, Visual Studio knows my project is under Git source control, and it knows my remote endpoint is on GitHub.com. So it's letting me know that I have the option of using CI/CD through GitHub Actions if that's how I want to get this application deployed to my destination. And I'm going to go ahead and do just that. By clicking Finish, what I'm asking Visual Studio to do is go and find the best GitHub Actions workflow template for myself, for this project type. And Visual Studio has done exactly that. It's telling me that this new workflow it has created is going to be triggered on the next push. And it has even told me not to worry about the publish profile secret, because it has gone ahead to the Azure portal. It has downloaded the publish profile. It has put it as a secret in my GitHub repo. And it has wired up this workflow, which, by the way, it's written in YAML. It has wired up this YAML workflow to use up that GitHub secret during publish. So all I have to do right now is to follow the instructions and commit this workflow locally and then push it remotely. So I'm going to go ahead and use my Git changes window. I'm going to commit and push. So this is taking my workflow that VS has created, committing it to my local repo, and then it's pushing it to GitHub.com as well. And because I know that my trigger is on push, Visual Studio has pushed the workflow, and it has also triggered the workflow to run. So Visual Studio is letting me know the current status of the workflow, why it's running, and it will even let me know when it finishes. But if I'm really curious and I want to know exactly what's going on every step of the way, all I have to do is just follow the link and go check it out. So here I am in GitHub.com, and I'm looking at this exact deployment as it's happening every step of the way. And I didn't have to do anything. I didn't have to customize anything. All I did was just ask Visual Studio to find one for me and just run it. All right, the deployment is complete. And if I go back to Visual Studio, it lets me know that's the case as well. All right, well, that was fun and pretty simple. I hope you thought the same as well. Our journey on GitHub Actions tooling is just starting, and would love to get your feedback on it. So please let us know what you think, either through social media or through developercommunity.visualstudio.com. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye.